we were talking about the biggest mistakes that the Trump administration has made, and I think probably it really goes back to Charlottesville, where a president took a position that basically supported Nazis and others who were demonstrating in Charlottesville. I think that sent a terrible signal to the rest of the country.
Excuse me for interrupting, Mr. Secretary, but this is a very important point. Given your experience, and I'm keeping in mind that you served some during Republican President Richard Nixon going all the way back to the 70s, has there ever been a time, including maybe especially the Nixon administration, when an American president even remotely associated himself with neo-Nazism and tried to strike some equivalency between neo-Nazism and dissent and protest from various sections? Has there ever been anything like it in our history?
I have never in my lifetime seen a president of the United States be willing to even begin to rationalize the position that Nazis and white supremacists take in this country. They have always been an abomination to what America stands for, and I think it's extremely important for this president and for all presidents to speak clearly about how the United States will not tolerate those kinds of groups who preach racism and divide our country, that they are not to be tolerated. And I think you know, one of the important roles of a president of the United States is to unify this country, to bring us together, not to divide us, not to speak to our prejudices or our fears, but speak to what's good about all Americans. That's the role that a president should embrace.